I know what you're thinking. Why is Tom Connelly wearing Dieter Euler's pajamas?
He looks good. Well, welcome, and it's truly an honor to be here, and I'm trying not to be emotional, but it might happen.
For the meal we are about to enjoy, for those that made it possible, and for those with whom we are about to share it, we are thankful. Namaste. Amen. Miigwech.
For everyone that has been part of Grand River that I know, you all have delivered the word worthwhile. I can only hope that over the next 50 years, all of the students get an opportunity to participate at the school, get to share in that same definition. Thank you very much for letting me say a few words. Again, thank you for tens of thousands of kids that have come through here that you've impacted both personally and professionally.
So I'm just so grateful to be here. I'm grateful for what Grand River did for me and to me, because I wouldn't have done any of that if it hadn't been for the support and for the growth that I had as a human being, as being part of this, you know, the staff that I was part of. So I think that's my 60 seconds, and that's it. Thank you very much.
May these goals remain true. May time never undo every light that this great school has shone. And in days yet to be, we will certainly see our amazing traditions live on. Here we go.
Oh, good. My brother still lives here.
Oh, yeah, Drew. Okay.
Got a monkey?
I thought, is there, maybe there's some new system. Yeah.
So it's not a traditional still picture, but.
And I still have my jacket.
Hey, Mr. Newton. Ron Starr here from your calculus class.
Scott Starr here as well.
Wish you were here.
Wish you were here.
Grand River 50th, 2016.
This is Bonnie Landers. This is one of my, actually, she's Bonnie Gingrich now. They had 13-year-old twin boys. Yeah. Her father was in the business department when I was here originally, when I started here in the 70s. Yeah. The nicest, kindest man. And I taught Bonnie, and I taught her brother Robin.
Yes.
And I left Robin behind on a field trip a few times.
Chef D believes in sharing his passion for food with others and keeping recipes simple, easy, and incredibly tasty, which we are so thankful for. Thanks, Chef D.
How are the Renegades tonight? It is great to be here. It's an honor to be here. I'm so excited. As mentioned, we did a little bit of a breakfast today, about 175 people. It's great to see some old teachers. That got me passionate about cooking, about being in front of people, and it's just been an amazing ride. And I'd like to introduce Debbie Terrell. Debbie, can you come up, please?
For the passion, work, and dedication of the GRCI 50th Organization Committee. An event of this magnitude has taken close to 2 years to plan, organize, and execute. The end result, a fabulous weekend to reconnect, reminisce, and a chance to celebrate our time at GRCI and our achievements. We truly have showcased 50 years of excellence this weekend. I would publicly like to acknowledge and thank alumni student Tamara Grant and alumni student and current staff member Brian Miller, the co-chairs of the 50th reunion organizing committee.
In recurring sweet dreams, we'll be here at the scene, and we'll wander those hallways of yore. Take a stroll through the V, there'll be visions to see of the past and the decades in store. May these walls remain true, may time never undo every light this great school has shone. And in days yet to be, we will certainly see our amazing traditions live on. All together now. Home at GRCI, where time continues to fly. There's a role we have played, many memories made, 50 years in the blink of an eye. Love you, Blue. Happy 50th. Thank you.
Thank you, Lee. But we both had the same goal, and that was a successful weekend. She did everything that anyone could possibly do to make this happen. I want to personally thank her. She has my utmost respect, appreciation, and affection, and I would like everyone here to stand and show their appreciation.
When he wasn't at a meeting, he was coaching, so anyways, it was a wonderful experience, and thank you, Brian. We would also like to thank a few more people. And although we want to keep it short, because if anyone knows me, I could talk forever. We would like to first thank our lead committee members. So if we could have every lead committee member please stand up, and if everyone could just give them a round of applause. Please don't be shy, please stand up. Lead committee.
Thank you, Deb. Yeah. Our second principal behind Deb is Scott Molex. So Scott, can you come up, please? Yes. Angus, can you come up, please? Great to see everybody. Gary, come on up. You're the next contestant. I want to give you the way, right?
Yeah.
And now Gary's going to come up and talk about our founding principal, Ross Shaver.
And 51 years ago, a man in the person of Ross Shaver was assigned the task of opening a new school over on the east side called Grand River Collegiate. Ross Shaver was in the Navy, a Navy vet. He went to University of Toronto and graduated in phys ed, came to the KW High School Board, and very quickly made a name for himself. Hard worker, caring about what happened in his school, and wanting to be a leader, and he was. He actually headed the then KW High School Board group of, and they call it headmasters at that time. I think it kind of sounded a lot better than principal. I'm not sure that that worked. And then he actually became the head of the Principal Headmasters Association for Ontario. That's the influence that Ross had. Now, I think it's important that we understand why we're here is because of him. Because he had a vision about what he wanted to see happen in the school. He had a very strong belief and set of values that said, this is my school, this is not a system school, this is why we're going to make this the best way we can. You know the first thing he did? He hired staff that he believed in and he cared about and he supported. And Ross strongly supported his staff at Grand River. So on behalf of you and me, I would say to the Shaver family, thanks for sharing. And Ross, I know you can hear me somewhere, and I won't point which direction you might be in. But thank you, Ross Shaver, for setting us up, making the things happen that needed to happen. So thank you.